Happy Veterans Day. My name is Barry Voigt, and I have the pleasure of serving as principal at Delano High School. For many years, Delano High School and the broader Delano community have had a strong tradition of recognizing Veterans Day and honoring those who have served. Unfortunately, our recognition this year must be done from afar. I'd like to welcome all of our student, family, and community viewers for remotely participating in our Veterans Day program. Most importantly, I want to extend a heartfelt thank you and my deepest appreciation to our veterans and their families. As Americans, we are all indebted to the men and women in our military because of the sacrifices they've made in service to past, present, and future Americans. Let us never forget that our enduring freedoms are the result of your sacrifice. At this time, it is my pleasure to invite Delano High School's Sound Revolution to perform our national anthem.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner
Each year, Delano American Legion Post 377 sponsors a scholarship essay contest for Delano High School seniors. I would like to thank Mr. Ted May and the judges from the Senior Center Writing Group for judging our essays again this year. On behalf of Post 377, I'd like to recognize and congratulate our three winners, Ellie Tolke, William Larson, and Amanda Stafford. At this time, Ellie Tolke, the overall winner of the essay contest, will present her essay.
When I think of patriotism, instantly what comes to mind is red, white, and blue, parading the American flag, and giving our thanks to the multitudes of veterans that serve our country every day. I recently have opened my eyes to a new reality of patriotism in our country. It isn't just celebrating our flag one day of the year, it's doing everything in our power to show admiration for our country and doing our part to protect it. Our country is in the middle of a global pandemic that is affecting each and every one of our brothers and sisters. Before this pandemic, I never in a million years would have realized that wearing a mask in public is showing considerable patriotism. Patriotism is the quality of being patriotic, devotion, and vigorous support for one's country. Wearing a mask to help support and protect our country and fellow citizens proves not only adulation for our country, but solicitous in our family, friends, neighbors, and individuals you may not even be aware you are helping out. I want to stress that it is not a crime against humanity to wear a mask. I wear a mask for my cousin who has battled cancer. I wear a mask for my grandparents due to their age. I wear a mask for my family, but most importantly, I wear a mask for my country, the United States of America. From wearing a mask to practicing social distancing, Americans have had to absorb many new realities of life. These crucial, patriotic sacrifices we make are for the cultivation of a strong, healthy community. I used to identify patriotism strictly with the veterans and armed forces of our country, but unfortunately, you can't shoot away a virus. Our frontline healthcare workers have been working ruthlessly, trying to protect the individuals of our country. They didn't sign up for this pandemic. They didn't choose to risk their lives every time they go into work, but here they are dedicating their lives to keep America healthy. That is patriotism. Nevertheless, I will continue to be grateful for the veterans that serve our country, but I will also value individuals not acknowledged for their patriotic commitments, such as healthcare workers. I will honor new symbols of American patriotism, and I hope you do too.
Thank you, Ellie, for a very well-written essay. As you so eloquently put, patriotism is defined as devotion to and vigorous support of one's country. Far too often, we demonstrate our patriotism only on national holidays, and even then, as is often the case with holiday celebrations, the true meanings are often pushed to the background. Each generation of Americans has been and will be presented with opportunities to support our country. When these opportunities arise, I encourage all of us to remember and honor the sacrifices of our veterans through our own calls to action. The reason for today's assembly is to recognize all those among us who have been a part of the great brother and sisterhood that is the United States military, our veterans, active duty service members, guardsmen, and reservists. It is your service and sacrifice that has kept our country safe and free. No matter what branch you served in, whether you were peacetime or wartime, whatever your job path or how many years you served, raising your hand and committing yourself to service in our military was a brave and selfless act. Remember, veterans have always put us and America first. Today, we put veterans first. We have the great fortune of living in the land of the free because of the brave. As we face the challenges that lie ahead, let us all commit to honoring veterans each and every day. On behalf of the Delano High School staff, students, and community, thank you for your service.